and welcome to my another online class. I'm Chef Aditya Saxena from Chitkara School of Hospitality. So today we would be learning about different spice mixtures of India. India, being a very vast country, has different cuisines in it. If we collectively say it, that comes to a term known as Indian cuisine. But if we differentiate it, we have 33 different major cuisines, and if we further segregate them, we have around 300 different cuisines. So when we have that much vast cuisines, we have different spice mixtures also. Well, there is a spice mixture in Maharashtra, there would be a spice mixture in West Bengal, there would be a spice mixture in Punjab, there would be a spice mixture in Tamil Nadu. So today we would be learning about those spice mixtures. Starting with the first one, that is Buddha Masala. Marathi delicacy. This is a darkish color masala, as you can see in the screen. Coconut based masala that is guaranteed to make an ordinary curry interesting. So what would be the ingredients for the Maharashtra Buddha masala? That would be 4 cups of coriander seeds, 1 cup of dry coconut, 1/2 cup of white sesame seeds. Now that will provide a nuttiness. With the coconut, the sesame seeds will also provide some nuttiness in the masala. Then 1/2 cup of black sesame seeds, 1/4 cup of cumin seeds, 4 to 5 black cumin seeds, teaspoon of black cumin seed. Black cumin seeds are also known as Shahi Zira, and in English it is also known as caraway seeds. After that, we have got 2 teaspoons of asafoetida, which is ghee. It is also known as devil's dung. Then we have got 1 tablespoon of cinnamon broken into tiny pieces, or we can say 1 inch of cinnamon, 3 to 4 cloves, 1 black cardamom. Only seeds are required in this, not the shell. 3 dry red chilies, 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, and the salt to taste. I would say a teaspoon of salt would, it will work really good with the spice mixture. Now, how would we make the Maharashtra Buddha masala? Now, we have to roast all the ingredients except coconut and coriander seeds in oil. Now, coconut again contain oil, so if you bring it in oil, it will be much more oilier. So, we have to roast all the ingredients apart from coconut and coriander seeds in oil, and we have to keep them aside. Then, on a separate pan, we have to roast coconut and coriander seeds separately without oil. We have to dry roast them. When the coconut became golden or golden brown, we have to take it off the flame. Same thing had to be done with coriander seeds. When they start crackling or they start releasing the pectins, then we had to take them out and had to place them in a plate so that they would just cool down. Now, when things will get cooled down, we have to mix them all together and then we have to grind them into fine powder. We can also strain it after making a powder of it so that there is no bits and pieces of any spice in it, and we can cool it and store it in an airtight container. Now, where would we be using Buddha masala? Now, the Buddha masala will be used in masala bhat or amti, any Marathi preparation, and you can add the Buddha masala in it. And it will, give a really robust flavor to your dish, and it will be, the flavor of the dish will be elevated. The next spice mixture is Pav Bhaji Masala, again a Marathi delicacy. But it has been loved by each and everyone across India, whether it is Punjab, Haryana, Himachal, Delhi, you take Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh. Pav Bhaji is loved by everyone. So, we would be learning about how to make Pav Bhaji Masala. Now, the ingredients would be 2 small black cardamoms, isse badi ilaichi bolte hain, ya kali ilaichi ya moti ilaichi bolte hain, 4 tablespoons of coriander seeds, dhaniya ke peas, sukha hua jo hote hain, 2 tablespoons of cumin zira, जिसका जीरा जो हिंदी में होता है, क्यों में उसका इंग्लिश वर्ड है, 2 टीस्पून ऑफ ब्लैक पेपरकॉर्न्स जो कि है काली मिर्च, 3/4 टेबल स्पून ऑफ फाइनल सीड विच इज सौंफ. सी अगेन हम लोगों ने काली मिर्च ऐड की है 2 टीस्पून जो कि हीट जनरेट करती है और उसकी हीट को काउंटर करने के लिए वी आर यूजिंग फाइनल सीड्स. 5 रेड ड्राई चिलीज, 1 स्टिक ऑफ सिनेमन, 6 पीसीज ऑफ क्लोव्स विच इज लौंग एंड 1 टेबल स्पून ऑफ ड्राई मैंगो पाउडर जिसे आप चूर भी बोलते हैं या पंजाब में आमचूर. मेथड कैसे बनेगा ये अगेन, यू हैव टू क्लीन द स्पाइसेस एंड डिस्कार्ड एनी फॉरेन ऑब्जेक्ट्स. देन सारे इंग्रेडिएंट्स जो हैं वो ड्राई रोस्ट होंगे वन बाय वन, एक साथ नहीं, वन बाय वन वो सारे ड्राई रोस्ट होंगे एक्सेप्ट अमचूर पाउडर. जो भी पाउडर्ड फॉर्म में आपके स्पाइसेस होते हैं वो कभी भी ड्राई रोस्ट नहीं होते. जब वो ड्राई रोस्ट हो जाए और हल्के गर्म हो then we had to add the amchur powder so that amchur powder unki garmi se hi garam ho aur apna aroma aur apne essential oils jo hai wo unme release karte aur fermented ho jaye. Then jab wo thande ho jaye then we had to blend them into a fine powder. Again if necessary usko chhan le aur usko airtight container mein jar mein band karke refrigerate kar sakte hain, freeze kar sakte hain for up to 6 months. So this is how your pav bhaji masala will look like. It is always better to make your spice mixtures in your home rather than going outside and purchasing it. The next is everyone's favorite Punjabi chole masala. हम लोग बाहर जाते हैं, छोले खरीदते हैं, उसका मसाला खरीदते हैं, घर आके चना मसाला या छोले मसाला डालकर हम लोग छोले बनाते हैं. Instead of that, हम लोग घर में ही छोले मसाले बनाएं तो जो छोले बनेंगे उसका जो फ्लेवर है इट विल इंक्रीज मैनी फोल्ड्स, बहुत ज़्यादा इंक्रीज हो जाएगा एंड इट विल बी डिश विल बी एलिवेटेड टू अ नेक्स्ट लेवल एंड द फ्लेवर्स वुड बी अमेजिंगली यू नो टेस्टी एंड पीपल विल लव योर छोले और चना. सो फॉर द पंजाबी छोले मसाला व्हाट वी रिक्वायर इज 2 टेबल स्पून ऑफ क्यूमिन सीड्स दैट इज जीरा, 1 टेबल स्पून ऑफ कैरेबे सीड्स या उसको बोलते हैं शाही जीरा, 5 dry red chilies, 1 teaspoon of turmeric जिसे हल्दी है and 1 piece of fresh turmeric. दोनों ऑप्शनल हैं, अगर आपके पास fresh turmeric है आप उसका 1 इंच का पीस ले सकते हैं, if you have powdered form of हल्दी उसका 1 teaspoon. Then we have got 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds. Coriander seeds again they are full of flavor और Indian cuisine में अगर देखा जाए coriander seeds जो है is a sort of backbone for our cuisine. Then 1/2 tablespoon of black peppercorns, 10 cloves, 1 tablespoon of white sesame seeds, this is a bit dil bolte hain, 10 green cardamoms, 4 black cardamoms, 1/2 teaspoon or tablespoon of 1/2 tablespoon of dry ginger, this is sont bolte hain, ya phir agar dry ginger ke aapke paas pieces pade hain to uske 2 pieces. Then 1 tablespoon of dry mango powder, जिसे अमचूर बोलते हैं, 5 sticks of cinnamon, दालचीनी के 2 bay leaves. Then we have got 1 star anise, which is chakri phool, 1/2 teaspoon grated nutmeg powder or a small piece of nutmeg जो कि we can blend easily. Then 1/2 tablespoon of rock salt or we call it black salt or kala. Again, इसमें चीजें बहुत सारी जाती हैं, सो वी हैव टू यू नो मेंटेन द रेशियो कि कोई भी चीज कोई भी यू नो नॉट अ सिंगल स्पाइस और पाउडर्ड फॉर्म और इन अ होल फॉर्म डोमिनेट्स द फ्लेवर ऑफ योर छोले मसाला. सो द मेथड फॉर कुकिंग छोले मसाला इज अगेन यू नो यू हैव टू ड्राई रोस्ट ऑल द इंग्रेडिएंट्स वन बाय वन except the spice powders. As I told you, spice powders ko hum log waise roast nahi karte, we can mix them in hot ingredients and they will release their essential oils. And when all the ingredients are roasted one by one, let them cool down. Once the ingredients have cooled down, we have to grind them into a smooth powder. And again, we can sieve it. If you know there are pieces of spices which are not grind it properly, they will be separated, and you can always you can use those pieces, those bits and pieces in your curries, or you can grind them and make a ball out of it. You have to sieve it, you have to store it in airtight container. Now there are some notes that you should know. The first one is you don't have to roast spices powder like amchur, saunf, haldi, rock salt, etc. because they are already in powdered form. If you apply heat on it, they'll discolor, their taste will be really bad, and ultimately your chole masala will be of no use. Keep a lid handy when roasting sesame seeds, as they will start to pop up. Just like popcorn, sesame seeds do pop up when they are tend to hot. So if one of the sesame seeds sticks on your skin, it will make a lasting impression on your skin. So it's always preferable to keep a lid handy when you are dry roasting sesame seeds. The next spice mixture is everyone's favorite biryani masala. Now, as per study of Zomato and Swiggy, biryani is the most ordered online food in India. This is the amount of love that we people have for biryani. It is the most hot selling online item. Online order सबसे ज्यादा बिरयानी का ही होता है. So let's make a biryani masala at your home, and you would be able to inculcate that biryani flavor in your homemade biryani. So there are a lot of spices that go inside the biryani masala. First is one piece of bay leaf, which is your tejpatta, 1.5 teaspoon of fennel seeds, which is saunf, 2 star anise, which is your chakri gul, 6 pieces of green cardamom, 2 pieces of black cardamom, 1 teaspoon of black peppercorn, 5 cinnamon sticks, 1 tablespoon clove, 4 tablespoon coriander seeds, 2 tablespoon of caraway seeds, that is your shahi zira, 1 mace flower, which is javatri, and 1/2 teaspoon grated nutmeg, 3 medium-sized stone flower, which is known as tagad phool in Maharashtra, and kalpasi in Tamil Nadu, patthar ka phool in Awadh. So it is the same ingredient but has different names. Now we can see there are some spicy ingredients in this. There are some ingredients which are subtle in flavor, some are sweet in flavor. So this all these things make a biryani masala a really wonderful spice mixture, wonderful and aromatic spice mixture. Now if you see nutmeg, mace, cinnamon, these 3 things are obtained from a single tree. Cinnamon is the skin of the tree, mace is the flower of the tree, and nutmeg is the fruit of the tree. So a single tree gives 3 different ingredients, and all those 3 ingredients have different flavor. Amazing, isn't it? So let's see the method how we had to prepare it. Now we had to clean and discard all the debris from the spices, and on a low flame we had to dry roast each of the spice separately, and we had to cool them. Alternately we can sun dry them. Sare spices ko ek saath mix kiya aur dhoop mein rakh diya ek ya do din ke liye, then you can dry roast it. Or you can use a high definition lamp, high heat lamp, uske niche isko rakh diya, you will dry them. Then when they are crisp and they are dried, we have to blend them in a fine powder. When we would be blending it, we have to make sure that the temperature of the jar remains normal, it doesn't get hot, otherwise the spices will lose their flavor. We have to blend them to a fine powder, then we have to sieve it, and then we have to store it in an airtight glass or container. Now use 1 teaspoon per cup of rice when making biryani. 1 teaspoon for 1 cup of rice would be sufficient, but if you want some more flavor, you can always add some more biryani masala. Now, there is a note here which is a word of caution that says do not put the coarse powder that is left after sieving it. जो भी कोर्स पाउडर जो भी दलदले दाने बचे हैं उसको यूज नहीं करना आपने बिरयानी में एज इट विल रुइन द डिश बट यू कैन पुट दोस थिंग इन योर करीज और चाय का मसाला. नाउ रोस्टिंग द स्पाइसेस और ड्राइंग देम इन द सन सन ब्रिंग्स आउट द एरोमा ऑफ द स्पाइसेस एंड प्रिवेंट द मसाला फ्रॉम गोइंग बैड और गेटिंग बर्न्स. यू कैन स्किप दिस स्टेप इफ यू विल बी रेफ्रिजरेटिंग द पाउडर. द स्पाइसेस warm up while they are being blended. If you like the flavor of sonf, you can increase the quantity to 1 or 1.5. Now, as I have told this just now before reading it, if you want your biryani masala to have more of a fennelish flavor, you can always add some more fennel in it and it will smooth out all the spices or the spiciness from the biryani masala. Similarly, some people also add dry rose petals in their biryani masala. It is again optional. It is on to you. If you want some rose flavor in your biryani masala, you can always add dry rose petals and you can just blend them with the other spices. So, this is it for today's session. And please stay safe, stay at home, wear a mask, maintain 6 feet distance and sanitize your hands. Keep washing your hands. Thank you. Thank you very much for the session.